If you believe your weapon wants to end all existence, then so will it. But more on that later. What's going on, Guardians? My name is the Black Link, back to bring you Guardians our coverage of the Destiny 2 summer event, the Moments of Triumph, and the Imperial Tribute Hall, both of which went live earlier today with the release of Destiny Update 2.5.1.1. And of course, as a part of the exotic quest tied to this, you can get your hands on the D1 classic exotic pulse rifle, the Bad Juju. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and dive on into it. Now, a lot of the stuff to do with the Tribute Hall is pretty self-explanatory, so we're going to go through this very quickly. First things first. The Tribute Hall is going to be a brand new personal location located inside of the Leviathan. You'll be able to access that world space the same way you do with the Menagerie. It'll be an icon right next to it. But before you can get access to it, you're going to need to head to the Nessus Barge. There, you'll need to talk to Wernerbot. He'll have a brand new mission for you. Picking this up will grant you access to the Tribute Hall. This mission will show up in the form of a brand new Imperial treasure chest. You'll need about 5k glimmer in order to open it up. Once you've done so, go ahead and load into that new world space. Once you've visited the Tribute Hall, go and speak with the giant visage of Kallus in front of you. This will serve as your Tribute Hall vendor for this event. After you've spoken to him, you'll receive the next part of the Invitation of the Emperor step, which is going to require that you complete at least one champion bounty. These bounties will be available from the visage, and upon completion will grant you what's called a Boon of Opulence. These boons will serve as kind of an extra form of currency that you'll utilize to lower the cost of the tributes that you'll be purchasing from the visage. Speaking of, you'll notice here he has several tributes. Now, the way this event is going to work is you're going to be collecting what are called tributes. These are essentially statues that you'll be putting up in the Tribute Hall. You can acquire tributes either by completing triumphs tied to the Moments of Triumph or the Tribute Hall itself. And you'll also be able to purchase some tributes directly from the Visage of Kallus for a variety of different in-game currencies and planetary materials. Over the course of this season, your goal is to complete as many challenges as you can, earn as many tribute statues as you can, and fill out your tribute hall with those statues. And doing so will net you all manner of rewards, including the exotic quest for the Bad Juju. Alright, so once you've picked up these bounties, you'll need to complete at least one of them to advance the quest. Thankfully, all of today's bounties are really easy. You can head out into strikes and go get a bunch of precision kills or 50 kills without dying. You should have at least one of these done in no time flat. And once you've done so, return to the Tribute Hall, speak with the Visage again, and you'll be able to advance this quest. This time around, he's going to give you two separate pursuits. One continuing the Invitation of the Emperor quest and a brand new exotic quest titled Golden Hero. For the Invitation of the Emperor, you're just going to need to offer up the tribute you got for completing the previous step. But for the Golden Hero quest, this is going to require that you set up a certain amount of tributes around your tribute hall. It's a multi-part quest step, but ultimately you're going to need to unlock at least 13 tributes in order to complete this. Really, this quest is going to say that you're going to need to offer up 18 tributes, but 5 of those tributes are going to be unlocked automatically as you complete steps of Golden Hero. So this is where the grind is either going to begin or really end for a lot of you Guardians out there. If you've been playing Destiny a ton, really since Forsaken came out, nonstop through all the seasons, you're likely going to have more than enough triumphs to get this step done instantly. At least that's kind of how it was with me. In order to offer up the 13 tributes you're going to need here, you'll need to complete challenges tied to your Moments of Triumph, some of the challenges tied to the triumphs for the Tribute Hall itself, and you'll likely have to purchase some of the tributes that are available from the Visage of Kallus himself. Any of those sources can grant you the tributes you'll need to place statues. But be warned, like I said before, if you're going to be buying some of the tributes from the Visage of Kallus, they are pretty expensive if you're somebody who hasn't spent a lot of time farming. These are going to cost legendary shards, bright dust, and a plethora of planetary materials. Not to mention tons of glimmer per purchase. Offering up those previously mentioned boons will drop the price of these, but very, very slowly. So get to work grinding up those triumphs, earning those tributes, and then filling out at least 13 slots, not counting the dogs surrounding the treasure chest in the middle. And like I said, as you meet the objectives of Golden Hero, you're going to get an additional 5 tributes to help you fill out that 18 you'll need to access the quest. Anyways, once you've gotten 18 total tributes, return to the Visage of Kallus, who will offer you up the new mission, Pest Control. Picking this up will open up the spooky chest in the middle of the tribute hall, and from there, you'll be able to activate a brand new exotic adventure, which is going to take you into an ascendant version of the Leviathan itself. This mission is really fun, but it's actually not all that difficult. There's not really a lot of darkness zones, so you don't have to worry about wiping. There's no overall time limit, so you can take your time going through there. There will be a few jumping puzzles, but basically you're going to be fighting through the Ascendant Realm, taking on a mixture of Cabal and Taken. And once you get to the end of that, when you take out the final boss, you will be rewarded with the D1 exotic pulse rifle, the Bad Juju. And believe me, it feels just as good as you remember. But there we go, that's a quick guide to the moments of triumph for this year, as well as a quick rundown of what the Tribute Hall is for. Like I said before, a lot of the stuff with this is pretty self-explanatory once you get into the game. Just make sure you're getting your triumphs done, and you should have plenty of tributes in no time. Now, let's take a look at the Bad Juju itself. This thing is coming back with its classic perk, String of Curses. Kills refill the magazine, increase damage for a short duration, and grants super energy based on the strength of String of Curses. Fires full auto. Veteran Guardians will remember this as the perk this weapon had back in D1, and it was really, really strong. I'm very happy to say it's pretty strong in Destiny 2 as well. String of Curses makes the Bad Juju an amazing pulse rifle to play with, simply due to the sheer number of beneficial abilities you have there. It acts as a stackable buff now, and you're able to stack the String of Curses up to times 5. And the effects are really pronounced. At 5 stacks, it basically doubles this gun's damage output. And the super growth you get per kill, while not insane, is definitely noticeable. I took this thing over into the Whisper mission, and with one wave of Shadow Thrall in the green room, I had like half of my super back. That's not bad at all. Not to mention the fact that the magazine refresh is complete. It fully restocks your magazine every single time you get a kill. The sheer number of benefits on String of Curses is absolutely fantastic. And with pulse rifles already being a pretty solid option in PvE and PvP, it leaves the Bad Juju as a really good feeling weapon. Maybe it's just because I'm playing on PC, but the weapon is more than stable enough for me to control. I'd imagine you throw one or two pulse rifle centric mods like Unflinching Pulse Rifle or Pulse Rifle Targeting, you're going to have a good time with this gun. And I can't wait to do some further testing on exactly how well this thing works out in the wild. But alright Guardians, there you go, that's your rundown for Moments of Triumph, that's your rundown for the Tribute Hall, and that's how you can get your hands on the exotic D1 pulse rifle, the Bad Juju. We've been waiting for this one for a while. But thank you all so much for watching, hopefully you enjoyed, hopefully it helped, and hopefully you won't have to do too much grinding to get your hands on this thing. But anyways, be sure to let me know what you Guardians think down in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed, feel free to drop a like, make sure you subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay up to date with all the latest stuff we're putting out. But alright Guardians, that's it for this one. Thank you all so much for watching. And as always, I am the Black Link. You Guardians, stay frosty.